Honorable panelists and experts from Sri Lanka, India, Malaysia, the Netherlands, European, and all participants that I cannot mention each. Dear friends and colleagues, good evening from Indonesia. Firstly, I would like to express my sincere gratitude to have the opportunity together with you at today's event and deliver an essential topic on the contribution of palm oil to Indonesia's economic development. Secondly, congratulations to Solidaridad for organizing the launch and media conference of Palm Oil Myth and Truth. Ladies and gentlemen, Indonesia's economic growth in 2021 shows improvement, even though it is being hurt due to the new variant of COVID-19. However, the government program to control the pandemic has successfully pushed the Indonesian economy to grow 7.07% in the second quarter and 3.51% in the third quarter in 2021. This achievement brought Indonesia out of economic recession and provided optimism to maintain economic recovery and growth momentum. Based on the Indonesian economic outlook 2021, the projection in the fourth quarter of 2021 will grow more than 5%, making the full year economic growth in 2021 estimated to reach 3.5% to 4%, while in 2022 it is targeted to reach 5.2%. Nevertheless, growth will depend on controlling the pandemic, the proper economic policy response, job creation, and readiness for transformation. We also be grateful that agricultural sector has grown consistently and has supported the national economy amid a pandemic. Agricultural sector GDP continued to grow positively in the third quarter of 2021, at a rate of 1.31%. Ladies and gentlemen, the multidimensional impact of COVID-19 has disrupted our social and economic activities. What is left for us is the agenda to advance effort to alleviate the social economic impacts of the crisis and rise again. We will need to put appropriate measures to respond to the impact and chart a course of transformative recovery. One of them is to improve the well-being of the people through increasing national income, with, of course, consideration of principles of sustainable development as a safeguard for the environment, social, and economy. Palm oil covers 16.38 million hectares of Indonesian land, spread in 26 provinces and 217 districts. And the majority grew in Sumatra and Kalimantan or Borneo Island. It is distributed to the state-owned plantation around 6%, private plantation about 53%, and smallholders nearly 41%. All palm plantations developed and occupied the already degraded land and turned into product. As global demand for edible oil keeps growing and used in almost everything human needs, palm oil is now the most consumed vegetable oil globally. With 58% of the global share, Indonesia is the world's biggest producer and exporter of palm oil by far. The palm oil industry has contributed around 3.5% to the GDP of Indonesia. Palm oil also contributed significantly to employment as a labor-intensive industry, absorbing more than 16.2 million workers, direct and indirect, and the industry has an enormous impact on job creation and has a strong backward and forward linkage to other sectors of the economy. In addition, around 3 million smallholder farmers and more than 4 million plantation workers were being involved in this business. It is undeniable that the palm oil commodity has also felt the impact of the COVID-19 pandemic. The palm oil export have decreased from 43.28 million tons in 2019 to 38.93 million tons in 2020. However, the value of palm oil export to the world has increased from 19.22 billion in 2019 US dollar to 21.63 billion US dollar in 2020. This condition happened because at the end of 2020, the price of CPO has rocketed to more than 1,000 US dollar per metric ton. And until now, in January 2022, the price of CPO was still high, reaching more than 1,300 US dollar per metric ton. Meanwhile, the value and volume of biofuel export experienced a very significant decline from 2018 to 2020. The domestic biodiesel or B30 mandatory policy is one of the factors besides the import restriction by other countries. China is still the leading export destination for palm oil derivative products with a value around 3.31 billion US dollar, followed by India and European Union at 3.2 billion US dollar and 3.15 billion US dollar respectively. Ladies and gentlemen, palm oil has supported the reduction of poverty and inequality. If we look back since 2000, the Indonesian palm oil sector has helped 10 million people out of poverty because of the factors related to palm oil expansion, and at least 1.3 million people in rural areas have been lifted out of the poverty line directly due to palm oil expansion. Moreover, the line graph compares poverty reduction between regions with palm oil expansion and no palm oil expansion from 2001 until 2010 in Indonesia. And during that period, the average poverty level for the region with no palm oil expansion has decreased from 20% in 2001 to nearly 14% in 2010. Meanwhile, the region with a palm oil expansion has dramatically declined from 2001 to about 11% in 2010. It shows the significance of palm oil plantation to regional economic development. Thus, it also contributed to the SDGs achievement number one, no poverty, and number 10, reduce inequalities. Compared to other vegetable oils, palm oil has more advantage in terms of production and productivity. It requires 0.23 hectares to produce 1 ton of crude palm oil, while other crops demand higher than palm oil. For instance, soybean consume 1.79 hectares, rapeseed 1.28 hectares, and sunflower 1.03 hectares. Palm oil also has the highest productivity level of other competitors globally, with more than 3.5 tons per hectare in 2020 and predicted to gain above 4.5 tons per hectare in 2030. Vis-a-vis with other vegetable oil productivity around 0.5 to 1 ton per hectare. Amidst the pandemic, palm oil has contributed significantly to economic development and has a positive impact. So the question now is, how can we affirm that palm oil contributes to the social and environment aspects? The answer is by implementing sustainable palm oil. Ladies and gentlemen, the market was also transformed and sustainable product become a trend in global supply chains. Sustainable certification is a worldwide change and has become a prerequisite for tradable products to get legally and access to the international market. With rising global demand for sustainable food and agriculture, the government of Indonesia has issued President Regulation Number 44 of 2020 regarding of Indonesian Sustainable Palm Oil Plantation Certification System. The enactment of new ISPO aimed to increase international market acceptance of our sustainable palm oil product. The regulation also aimed to enhance the acceptance and competitiveness of sustainable palm oil product, the effort to accelerate greenhouse gas emission. In this opportunity, let me express my assurance that the government of Indonesia is committed to the independence and transparency of new ISPO. A professional team will implement the ISPO secretariat while the certification body will grant the ISPO certificate. Transparency is expected to help increase international recognition in the world. The new ISPO is equipped with several improvement with seven principles, which are compliance with law and regulation, application of good agriculture practices, environmental management, natural resources and biodiversity, labor responsibilities, social responsibility, and community economic empowerment, application of transparency and continuous business improvement. The government also obliged all business actors with a transitional period of 5 years for smallholders, which will also be supported in fulfilling the certification requirements. Ladies and gentlemen, palm oil policy has become highly internationalized and complex, characterized by policy spillovers, unequal level playing fields, and the struggle of data versus data. There are many challenges ahead, but I believe that all can be solved. Then the following question is, could banning and restriction or setting up a discrimination policy toward palm oil become a solution? The wise answer is no. I will leave it there and let the study by the expert reveal the truth, or there was only just a myth about palm oil. I hope everyone will enjoy and contribute to this event positively. Thank you very much.